This is part three. As I look at the scripture, I saw the Lord and he was high and lifted up, and his train filled the temple. You know, like musicians just kind of stay in a pocket, or they just, you know, rewind or get a groove going or get a loop in there and they stay with that and just work it. Let's just stay with I saw. Okay? Because the scriptures, I saw the Lord and he was high and lifted up and the strain filled the temple. Let's stay with I saw. Let's stay with I. Not my mom and them. Not my grandma. Not my pastor or the senior women or the prayer team or the intercessors. It says, I, just as I am, without one plea, I, it is me, O Lord, standing in the need of prayer. When it comes right down to life, you've got to show up. And when you show up, you have to be authentic. Not you showing up for someone else or somebody else is your proxy. You've got to be the I to get from point A to point B. Even if somebody takes you, you have to be present in the moment. And so when it says, I saw, then the responsibility is not on somebody told me, and hearsay and rumors and what somebody's testimony is or what your mama said. You've got to get to a place where you're present in the moment, your authentic self. You show up open and willing to see. There's a song, open my eyes, Lord, we want to see, open my eyes, open my heart, Lord, I want to see. So here it goes, I saw. So he is the one who sees. I know it's rudimentary and I'm kind of rolling around here with it, but the importance of seeing the Lord high and lifted up, you've got to know for yourself. You have to know for yourself. You know, like Thomas said, I got to see this for myself. I got to stick my hands where the nails had been. I need to know for myself. And I'm not asking you to be a doubting Thomas, but you've got to show up. You've got to be present in the moment. You can't go by religion and ritual and habit. You've got to show up and be present and be authentic and be a true worshiper in spirit and in truth. I saw. And he just didn't just, I think I'm seeing, I saw it, I get it, I got an aha moment, I figured it out, I can see clearly now, I can see clearly, I saw, I see with my inner man, I see with my heart, I see. God goes to and fro looking for someone he can show himself strong to. And he's looking for somebody who's looking back at him and say, yes and amen, we can do this. We got this, God. If you said so, we got it. I saw. You know, thank God for Jesus. Because we were in spiritual darkness. We did not see. We could not see our way out. We were groping in darkness, not knowing we were in darkness. But Jesus came and he is the light of the world. Now he lights every soul that enters the world. And we don't know that when we come into the world, even as children, creating the image and likeness of God, our hearts desire to connect with God. And so we look for love in all the wrong places. But then one day we see the Lord high and lifted up above our circumstances, high and lifted up above our situation, high and lifted up above our idol gods, high and lifted up above ourselves. He is God, and he is God alone, God all by himself. And we see this high and lifted God who loves us. I see you, God, because you've opened my eyes that I might see. You've given me a seeing heart and a listening spirit, and I've inclined my heart to you. So if you want to see God high and lifted up, can't go by hearsay. Can't go by mama's testimony, grandma's testimony. You got to know for yourself. Seek him. Seek ye first the kingdom of God. Delight yourself in the Lord. He'll give you the desires of your heart. He goes to and fro looking for somebody he can show himself strong to. It says that faith pleases God because we must first believe that he is. I saw he is. I saw that he is. And if I see that he is, then I seek him diligently. That's the God. And he's the El Shaddai. That's the God I'm looking for. And he's my Yahweh Shalom. He's a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. And you can't seek after something you don't see in your heart that you desire. God is looking for true worshipers. Those who seek him early, those who set their affections above and not on earth where moth can corrupt and thieves can break in. Do you see what I see? Do you see him high and lifted up? See, if you're in darkness, the darkness cannot understand, or if you're in death, you can't understand the things of the spirit because they're life. But God has taken out our stony heart, given us heart of flesh, and he's given us his spirit to lead us in all truth. So we can see God in his rightful place, and we see God in his rightful place, we can see who we really are. But we have to see God. Besides him, there is no other God. The Elohim, the El Elyon, the Most High, the Sovereign God. I saw. I got this. The Lord high and lifted up, and his train filled the temple. I saw. Okay, so I hope that blesses you to have greater vision by accepting God's plans and purposes for your life by seeing God where he is. And guess what? In Christ, we're seated in heavenly places. Wow. Together in this unity. Wow. When you see God and him high and lifted up, and we're sitting in heavenly places, there is a vantage point view of everything then. We'll see there's more for us than against us. We'll see that he's working all things together for our good, because God is even in this situation. And even if it looks tough, God is, he's in the fire with me. When I go through the storm, he's there. You know, he's with me. He will never leave me or forsake me. Whatever situation you are in, God is there. If you make your bed in hell, God is there. I saw. You're never alone. I saw the Lord, and he was high and lifted up, and his train filled the temple. Okay, God bless you. Have a wonderful day. May you feel lovely, 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 and be fantastically well, because above all things, I wish you prosper and be of good health, even as your soul prospers. So I hope that this little interpretation of the scripture helps your soul to prosper. God bless you real good.